Hi guys, welcome to the multi-award winning Emerald House of Cars. We're a totally unique family run business on a mission to be the best car dealership in the UK. Our commitment is to give you guys the best buying experience you've ever received, whether you plan on purchasing completely online using our free next day delivery service with 7 day money back guarantee, or you're coming to the showroom to meet the team. We've made everything as easy and as transparent as possible so that you've got full confidence in choosing Emerald for your next car. A little later in the video, we'll show you how our vehicles are prepared before sale in our on-site RAC approved service center. But for now, sit back, relax, and enjoy the following video.
Hello there guys, and welcome to Emerald House of Cars. I'm Greg, I'm your host today on the virtual walk around of the stunning new arrival, our VWE Golf. Yep, the Golf has gone all electric, baby. And what a fantastic offering this is in the full EV range. Now you don't have to have a car that looks too futuristic, too concept-y, a bit weird. This is just a standard Golf with an electric motor that's not going to cost you the earth. It keeps Greta happy, keeps your money in your pocket, very fuel efficient, very friendly for the economy, and very friendly for the environment as well. So what's not to love? And we're going to start off down here. You can see the only concept-y thing on these are the alloy wheels. Why manufacturers do it, I don't know, but I've got to argue they actually look very, very cool. Diamond cut in gloss black and chrome. Moving around, you can see you've got that deep metallic black all the way across the paintwork. If we're getting close, you can see the metallic fleck is even doing its thing in this dusk light this evening. Moving around, you can see you've got your LED light bar just down on the front splitter. You've got front parking sensors, and you've got the blue livery, as opposed to what you'd have the red on the GTI, of course, the GTE and the electric range are all blue. You can see you've got your headlights here as well with a chrome embezzlement, and you've got that honeycomb grille just running alongside them. Coming back and panning out, you can see you've got the chrome on the front splitter, your radar on the front for your front assist, and you've also got front parking sensors and the e-Golf badging, which is blue and chrome in a white housing as well. You've got nice shut lines all the way across the bonnet to give it a nice presence. And again, it's a VW Golf. You know what they look like, you know what they represent, but this one, the only difference is it's got the electric motor in there. You've got body colored door mirrors with built-in indicators, black rubber window surround, so there's no chrome on there, which is a real nice touch. Body colored door handles as well to emphasize the fact. Gloss black B pillars, but no tinted privacy glass, as it is, of course, a family car. You don't need this to be all blacked out. And what you have got though is a gloss black C pillar, rear spoiler, high level brake light, rear wiper, and sweeping rear lights just on there as well. You can see you've got the sweeping indicator function, and you move down and round, you've got rear parking sensors on there as well. In order to open the boot, what you can do is hold the middle button on your key. That'll unlock it. It won't unlift it, it'll just unlock it. Great use of English there, Greg. And you can see in here, you have, of course, got your charging port for charging up your vehicle. Now, underneath that, you've got the charging bag, and you can see spare space for storage as well. And to close the boot, it's not electrically adjustable, it is manual. So just close it nice and gently, and that will close it down. Now, in terms of presentation, overall, the car looks absolutely fantastic. Very well looked after by its previous owner, and one that we're very, very pleased to offer here as part of our stock taking. Now, we're going to carry on to the whistle stop tour. What we're going to do is head in to the rear first, and you can see no leather in this. You've got a checkered fabric cloth on there. You've got the line work as well down the center, almost pleated, if you will. And you can see you've got ISOFIX points on both the outer rear seats. Third seat in the middle is just, of course, a little one. And you can see you've also here got the fantastic dual cup holder and load through feature as well, just here. Now, moving round and down, you can see space in the rear for occupants. And Golfs are known for doing everything and doing everything well. And in terms of style, design, practicality, and space, this one is no different at all. What you can see on here, nice seating, same fabric, big comfortable cushion bolsters for support, manually adjustable as well. You've got your black, of course, on your trim work down here to save it. Black mats, you've also, of course, got rubber pedals. Moving across, you've got that deep titanium grey brushed aluminium. Now on here, you can see you've got heated, electrically adjustable mirrors that are also auto-folding as well. Central locking, chrome, and then you've got that combination of fabric and black plastic with chrome. And then we get inside, and it's the Golfs that you know and love. You can see here, auto lights, and you've got that deep metallic grey all across the cabin, all the way down the centre console. And then moving up, you've got that brushed aluminium just on your interior trim, just there. Now, to turn the Golf on, very easy, very simple. Take the key, pop it in the ignition, turn it 2-3 clicks, let the dash initialise, let it get sorted, let it turn itself on. And then the easy option to do now is foot on the brake, turn it on, and listen to that engine. Hang on, listen to that. Yep, that is now turned on. There is, of course, no noise as it is the electric motor. Now, what you can see on here is you have got the mileage, which is under 22,000. So it's a very, very low mileage car, very well looked after, and again, presented how you'd wish. Now, on here, you can see you've got your charge. You've also, of course, got your revs as such, and you've got your power outage here, which is very similar to what you get on CVT hybrid cars as well. You can also see you've got your normal and your max options down here. You've got your battery range, and you've got your speedo just here. Now, you can change the view in the middle by using the right-hand instrument cluster. You can scroll down. You can see your previous destinations. You can go across on your assist systems. You've got active, of course, the adaptive cruise control, speed limit, front assist as well. What you've also got on there is your driving data. You can have your digital speedo, average speed, distance, journey, electric range, consumption figures. You can also go on vehicle status. If there's any issues or any problem, like it tells you you need petrol. Just thought I'd try it, see if it got you. You can, of course, see them there. You've got Bluetooth telephone, audio source, and of course navigation again, which will give you your direction of travel or any indications or directions you need to be aware of. Now, moving down from there, you can see you've got your high beam settings just here. It's not auto high beam or high beam assist, just standard high beam. You've got indicators, and on this side you can see you've got your wiper settings. Now, on the steering wheel, it has to look good, as it is, of course, still a VW Golf, soft touch leather. For me, what I actually prefer is the blue contrast stitching, I would argue, and be a bit controversial and say it looks better than the red you get on the GTI, but I think that about the GTE as well. Flat bottom, and you've got the piano gloss black and chrome. You've also, of course, got your voice control options just here, which are ready to go. They don't require an activation key. Instrument cluster menu and audio options. And on this side, you've got, of course, your options for your front assist. You've got your assist systems, cruise control as well. Then we move across and down, air vents, hazard lights, fans, and then you come down to your touchscreen media option, which is a real nice addition in here. So you can see if you go on menu, you've got your radio option here. Click on banding, DAB, FM and AM. Bluetooth telephone, you can see you connect your iPhone as well. You've got media options. If you click on source, you'll be able to see you've got jukebox, SD, times two of those, CD and DVD, Bluetooth audio, USB and WLAN. You can also go on here, click on vehicle. You can see you bring up your trip computer on there. You've got your different selection modes. You've got your e-display. Now, this is quite cool. What this does is give you a virtual interpretation of your car and gives you an idea of how much charge is in the battery, what it's doing, how the car's performing. It's something that I found in my own hybrid a very, very cool. Obviously, this is a full EV, but it's the same sort of thing. Now, on here, you can see, excuse me, you've got your e-manager, and that, of course, gives you different options to change on here. You can do charge immediately, change your temperature and the aircon as well. Excuse me. Now, if you click across, you can see you've got your recuperation figures here, and you've also got your range monitor just there, and it gives you your blue score out of 100. If you go on media, you see you can change your options just there as well. Go on selection, you've got your driving data, which we've seen. You can go on your Think Blue trainer, which of course brings up a nice display, giving you an option and tells you, Greta, how well you've been saving the planet. And you can also go on vehicle status, and that'll give you any issues that you need to be aware of. You can also change your TPMS just there. Now, if you go on settings, you can see you've got ESC. You can change your tyres on there. You can change your speed warning. Personalisation, you can set your own driver account. You've got your light options here. Light assistance, interior lighting, coming home and leaving home function. Driver assistance, adaptive cruise control, front assist, eco tips, driver alert and occupant protection. You've also got parking and manoeuvring on there. You can see that you have, of course, got the park pilot option and manoeuvre braking. Mirrors and wipers, electric and charging, which we've seen already. And you've got time and date, units and, of course, service. You can see your next one isn't due for just over 140 days. And then you scroll across, you can see if I click back on menu, I can bring it all up. There's the navigation option, gives you a nice big digital display, big open screen, really high contrast and high resolution. I've also got the CarNet, I've got App Connect, so for Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, subject to device compatibility, you plug your USB in and it works just there. You've also, of course, got your traffic alerts, and then you go across, you've got your media control, you've got your sound images settings, and of course your digital aircon option here. You have got the quick clear windscreen. Now what that means is if it will zone in, you can see hopefully those zigzags just there are heating elements. That allows you when your car is in those real awkward winter months to clear the windscreen in quick time. And then we move down from there now. As you can see, we've finished on that option. You have, of course, here got the fantastic dual zone aircon, meaning I can have separate temperatures across the cabin for the driver and passenger. I've also got the air distribution, recirculation, heated front, heated rear screen, turn it off, sync the temperatures, aircon on or off, auto mode, or I can get back onto the menu just there, giving you an interpretation using blue and red and different colours and arrows to simulate where the air is into the cabin. Now in here, I've got the eGolf livery, click that up. Nice fluid storage system here. I've got my rubber matting, of course, on here for your phone, for your wallet, for anything you want to keep hidden. I've got your USB just down here. And you can see, close that, eGolf livery. I've got the different driving modes just here, which are of course normal, eco and eco plus. So there is no sport mode for those who are asking, but you can guess that these are of course here to save the planet that bit more. I have of course on here got the electronic engine sound either activated or deactivated, so you can have it silent or you can have it portrayed through the cabin to give you a louder noise and sensation of being in a car with an engine. You've also got audible parking sensors and you've got your DSG or CVT gearbox just here. What you can see, lever on the back, press it down. Once you're in reverse, it will beep. You'll see your park pilot kick in, neutral, drive, and then of course you've got your assistance options here in terms of going down the hill or having any issues with the CVT gearbox. Now what you can also do, push it across, down, push it across, and you can see you can change the gears manually using this if needed. Moving down and round and across, what you've also got here is your electronic parking brake. You've got your auto hold, your key holder, 12 volt charger, and of course dual cup holder under here. Just back to the gearbox, remember this doesn't mean you can change your gears manually, that's me getting used to it normally. That of course changes your recuperation level in between. That's me getting that mixed up with the DSG box. Now on there you can see, lift up there, plenty of storage as well. But I've had nearly 13 minutes of your time going through this fantastic offering in the EV range. Don't think you have to buy a Nissan Leaf, a Fiat 500e, or anything that lacks that little bit of normality. You can have a VW Golf, fully electric, and it's normal, practical, and fantastic for everyday driving. And what also is fantastic is knowing that this car has, of course, been treated to the Emerald 128-point check prior to retailing. That just means that our on-site facility has, of course, given it a thorough cosmetic and mechanical inspection prior to me making this video. For more information on our finance offers, part exchange rates, or our click and deliver eligibility, please speak to your designated salesperson. But for me, Greg, here at Emerald House of Cars, thank you very much for watching. Catch us on social media, and I'll see you on the next video.
One of the most important factors when buying a used vehicle is figuring out who to trust. Buying a car is a massive financial commitment and you need to be 100% confident in the company that you choose. We have over 1,000 five-star reviews on Google, Facebook and Auto Trader, hundreds of video testimonials, and the jewel in the crown are the multitude of awards we've won over the past number of years, including UK Independent Dealer of the Year, Independent Community Dealer of the Year, and most recently, Used Car Retailer of the Year. Integrity and transparency are really important to us at Emerald in how we conduct our business. We're the only dealership with a multi-award winning weekly YouTube show, which pulls back the curtain and lets you see the inner workings of how a car dealership operates. We cover all aspects of the day-to-day running, from buying, selling, sourcing, after sales, and of course, everything that goes on over at our RAC approved workshop.
Every one of our cars undergoes 128 point vehicle inspection by our team of experienced technicians. Any item that aren't up to our approved standards, we rectify and replace parts needed with manufactured approved parts. We also service every car and put a fresh MOT on ready for its next owner. When we are happy the car is in A1 mechanical condition, over it goes to our body shop for paint correction or wheel refurbishment, then finally onto our detailing team. Essentially, we want to ensure that when the car reaches its new owner, it's at its very best. For the road ahead, we've got you covered with a comprehensive 90-day warranty, which can be extended for 1, 2, or 3 years, depending on your preference. We are proud to be partnered with the market-leading warranty providers that match up to our own high standards, providing customers with genuine support when they need it.
We've also got you protected for all unfortunate circumstances, such as having your car written off or stolen throughout your time holding the vehicle. We're really pleased to be able to offer a great RAC gap and return to invoice insurance product, keeping you safe long after you've left our showroom.
If you were local to us and want us to take away the headache of keeping your car well maintained, our service plans could be just the ticket for you. Payable monthly and carried out in our fully equipped RAC approved garage, every service comes complete with a free health check to keep you and your vehicle safe and secure on the journey ahead, and also protect the future value of your car by maintaining that all important service history.
And when it comes to protecting your car's interior and exterior against stains, scuffs, contaminants, all of our encompassing Gardex paint and fabric protection ensure the aesthetic appearance of your new vehicle remained unaltered and improved to an almost better than new finish. It's a great opportunity to protect against the best and worst that Mother Nature has to offer.
And last but not least, if you do need to take out finance for your new vehicle, we have a panel of over 35 lenders, including Santander, with rates as low as 7.9% APR, always guaranteeing you the lowest possible interest rate. For a free finance check, which won't affect your credit rating, click the finance tab on our website to fill out a 2-minute application that lets you know beforehand what your monthly payments are likely to be. We've got loads of PCP, HP, and lease options available, depending on your personal preference and budget. So if you want to speak to me or my team of finance experts for any help and advice, please don't hesitate to pick up the phone. We're here to help.
Our goal at Emerald is not just to sell cars, it's about creating lasting relationships and customers for life. But don't just take our word for it. Here's what some of our customers had to say about their very own Emerald experience.
And how would you rate us out of 10? 10 being probably the best car dealership in the UK.
Definitely 10.
Oh, I'd definitely say 10.
I'm going to say 10.
10.
10, obviously.
10.
10, I suppose.
Definitely a 10.
I would give you a 10.
It's got to be a 10.
I'd give you a 10.
Well, it's obviously a 10, isn't it?
Obviously a 10.
Mate, it's more than 10.
Can I say 11?
Straight million.
Straight million.
Way more than 10.
I would say 10.
Oh, I'd go as far as saying 11.
Definitely a
10. 10,
yeah.
A 10.
I can say 10.
In the 11.
Which got to be a 10.
Definitely a 10. If I could give you more than a 10, I definitely would.
I'd definitely say a 10.
10. I'd give you a 10.
I'd give it a solid 10.
I would say 10.
10 out of 10.
I'll give you a 10 then. Sounds
give
good.
Give it a 10.
10. And I'll give you a 10 out of 10.
Gotta be a 10.
I'll give you a 10.
I would rate you a 10. 10 out of 10, 100%.
It's gotta be 10 out of 10, right?
That's an easy one, isn't it? It's 11.
11 out of 10.
I'll give you 10.
Perfect.
Because I came back, didn't I? And perfect. I'll be back again.